I'm Jason Borelli, head wrestling coach at Stanford University, and you're watching Pac-12 Bay Area.
On campus here at Stanford University, welcome to a Pac-12 beach volleyball doubleheader. The Stanford Cardinal carry a number 14 national ranking, and they play host to Boise State, and a bit later on this afternoon, Arizona State as well. As of March the 5th, here is the AVCA coaches poll, with USC the highest rated Pac-12 program at number 2, UCLA part of the top 5, and Arizona rounding out the top 10, with Stanford and Washington also holding a national ranking. And hope you're having a great start to your weekend. I'm JB Long with Olympian Nicole Brana. We've got an amazing day of Pac-12 beach volleyball coming, and the Stanford Cardinal are on a roll.
They certainly are, and they are clicking well together. I talked to Coach Fuller earlier today, and he said the blocking has really taken them up to that next level. They have such a strong net presence and really able to put a lot of pressure on teams this year.
Yeah, part of their winning streak has been led by their two pairing. They are the Pac-12 pair of the week, in fact. And Morgan Hentz and Amelia Smith.
And they are off to a great start. They started off a little rocky at 0-4, but since then they have had four straight wins. They are communicating well, moving well on the court, according to Coach Fuller. And this is the first weekly honor for them. And he said they're scrappy players and they will run every ball down. And I look forward to seeing that today.
Unlike the Cardinal, Boise State just getting its season started. Of course, a cold weather program, and so Drew Hannenman, a freshman from Flagstaff, makes her debut today at the Stanford Beach Volleyball Stadium. This group just lost a straight sets match to San Jose State. Cassidy Simon, her partner, a sophomore from West Liberty, Iowa. And it's a really great multi-team event from the Pac-12. Arizona State and Cal are here, locally San Jose State, and another great national program emerging, Tulane, providing a lot of opportunities for competitive matches here today, Nicole. And the Hannenman-Simon pair will go up against the Fives for Stanford. And Kat Anderson, now a sophomore from Everett, Washington, at 5'9", her teammate Caitlin Keefe. They won straight sets against that Tulane program yesterday, and part of a really emerging Stanford beach volleyball program. They'll look to start their doubleheader day with a win against Boise State. Well, first thing we notice is the conditions are excellent. Not as warm as perhaps you and I might like, but most notably, no wind, which means makes it a little bit easier strategically for our pairs to start.
That's right, and I think Boise State used to this kind of weather. As the coach Garris said, when it's 50 degrees, they bundle up, and that's when they get to go outside and train, so this is probably perfect for them. And as we know, Stanford is used to this kind of weather too, so not having that wind factor is a nice feature always. So speak some good volleyball out here today.
Yeah, four courts at this remarkable facility, and there are so many teams here that we're kind of splitting them, so to speak, with Boise and Stanford competing on two courts, and that means we'll have three flights of action today. We'll be keeping an eye on this five showdown to begin, and then our second flight will have pairs 3 and 4, and we'll finish with the top two pairs in our third flight. Best out of the five matches wins the duel. And in terms of beach volleyball rules, in case this is your first telecast with us on Pac-12 Network, 21 points to win sets 1 and 2. If a third set is necessary, first to 15 must win by 2, of course, in each set.
Always nice to get those done in 2.
And Stanford with all their momentum and success, winners of 6 in a row following a 4-1 defeat of number 18 Tulane yesterday, now takes on Boise State. Before we have the first serve on court number 5, tell us about Boise State and Stanford inside the match.
Well, the keys today for Stanford is going to be their net presence. They're a very tall team. They can put a lot of pressure on Boise State at the net for side-out game and in those transition rallies. Boise State, they have good serves, so get back to that service line. Give Stanford a hard serve to pass and put them in some side-out trouble so they can pull off the net, make some digs, and keep those transition plays going. Both the teams need to take care of the free balls when you get an opportunity. Give your partner a great pass, set, put that ball away to get those, as we call them, kind of the easier points in the match where you can take advantage of those chances you get.
Boise's a hybrid indoor-outdoor program in terms of their roster composition. They've been to Stanford before, and their roster really enjoys coming to the Bay Area and playing at this facility. Stanford gets the first point. Side out courtesy of Caitlin Keefe.
Nice little high roll shot over the block there on the line.
Kat Anderson to serve. Pick out Anderson on serve receive, and she'll get a swing with the block falling off the net, picked up by Boise State.
Watch for Boise State on side out defense and transition, maybe to pull a little bit more. And when I say pull, that means they're going to start at the block at the net, and they may pull off to do two down defense. That's more of a strategy for them. They're not the tallest team out here, but they're very scrappy, and if you're a good puller, you can make a lot of good digs on people.
There's a block by Caitlin Keefe. Now played most of her freshman season with Morgan Hentz.
Nice little almost swing block there by Keefe. Got right in front of the blocker, or the hitter, putting some good pressure, lining up well.
And follows it up with a nice serve. Keefe is splitting her weeks between beach and indoor, 3 days a week out here, and then 2 days per week training with the indoor team. Pacific Palisades product from Southern California. And again hitting around the block, Cassidy Simon able to get the side out for Boise. Recruiting's going in a great direction for the Stanford program, according to Coach Andrew Fuller, as they build out a beach-only roster, training year-round, year by year.
Great serve down the line there, and that's exactly what I was talking about before, just keeping that tough serve there on the end line for Boise State and keeping the pressure on Stanford to get those good points for them.
And changing on the sevens. I wouldn't say an advantage to either side of the court necessarily, with the sun currently hidden and no wind to speak of.
Good time to go back to the same player right now. They just kind of shanked a ball off the side, so get that ball back to them and keep them thinking about it.
Handled well this time by Kat Anderson. Reputed as a really good setter. That time she gets the kill and a 2-point lead for the Cardinal. First to 21, win by 2 in the opening set. Simon couldn't handle that serve receive.
Kind of trading aces there. You aced me, I'll ace you.
But to your point, let's see if they go back to Simon with Anderson at the service line, and they do. A much better handle this time, and Simon gets a kill.
Nice kill there, and just the blocker pulled but hadn't quite stopped yet. Threw that arm out there, and the ball just kind of went off to the side there. Hard for her teammate to recover, but if you can pull off the net and get stopped, as soon as they're hitting the ball, that's going to give you the best chance to make a balanced move.
Oh, long run, and Simon able to keep it alive. At least momentarily. You know, the expectations for Boise, their goals this week, and a little bit different than some of the other programs that are here because of how early it is in their season.
Nice hustle there by Simon, but as we know, or if you don't know, but when the block touches the ball, you have to get that ball over in two contacts. So the block counts as one touch. Just wasn't able to get that ball back over. And yes, Boise State, this is their first weekend of matches, so they're coming out. Stanford has been playing already some games this year and has a little bit of momentum coming into this weekend. So Boise State needs to kind of feel that out, get into the game rhythm, and you know, it takes a little time, a little nerves going probably.
four straight points for Anderson and Keefe, playing the fives to open this first flight of action. A doubleheader day for Stanford Beach Volleyball with a duel against Arizona State coming up next. Caitlin Keefe picking her spots on serve to keep this roll going. Five straight now for the Cardinal five pair.
That was a smart serve. Just dropped right there in the middle.
And more trouble on serve received for Boise State.
Nice serves by Keefe. And one option Boise State could do is switch sides if they're having trouble with the passing, just to give the server a different look.
Finally, the Broncos get the side out they'd been looking for. And Drew Hannenman will step back to the service line. It's been a while since they had to serve, so I think just getting an order. Turns out it's Simon's turn. Hard sinking serve, well done by Cassidy Simon.
Both teams are putting the pressure on from the end line. Serves seem to be dropping a little bit short, so both of these teams I think can make an adjustment, maybe one step forward and force them to serve you deep.
Simon again tried to go short. Just missed the deep line shot, asking for a deflection off the block, but our referee saw it differently. Brilliant serve there by Kat Anderson.
Really getting after it behind that line and keeping the pressure on. Hard to recover when you're struggling on the side out and they just keep acing you.
First flight of action, and Anderson Keefe looking to get the Cardinal off to a fast start.
You're watching 12 Bay Area.
Pac-12 Beach Volleyball is brought to you by State Farm, here to help life go right. Oh, one of the great things about being here on the farm, so much activity around campus, including the Stanford Beach program, winners of six in a row.
Now, we feel like we're going to be better at the end of the season than the beginning, and we really wanted to set that tone early playing UCLA and University of Hawaii, who are two top five programs right now, and I don't have momentum, we're just learning a lot.
Welcome back to Stanford Beach Volleyball Stadium with Nicole Brana. I'm JB Long. This is the five pairing, getting our three flights of action started in this doubleheader. First Boise State and the Cardinal, and then Stanford will host a Pac-12 rival in ASU. Caitlin Keefe and Kat Anderson with a comfortable advantage on this court against Drew Hannenman and Cassidy Simon. Nicole, just to follow up on the thought from Andrew Fuller there, his program challenged itself with a couple of talented opponents early in the year, took a few defeats, but they've stabilized and started to string some winning efforts together.
Yeah, they had a couple defeats there against top teams, like you said, and in that tournament the next day they came back and scored more points against them. They didn't win the duel, but they did improve the next day, made some changes, and I think that's an important part to a program and to the student athletes, is being able to see what you can do in a loss and then the next day make improvements. And they've been doing a great job here so far, and it's been fun to see this program develop and just improve each year.
It was 6-4 at one point in this opening set, but Anderson and Keefe have taken command. Timeout over on the five pairing. And again, this is a race to 21, win by two to claim the opening set. How critical is it in Beach to grab that opening set?
It gives you momentum. It gives you that confidence. There's a little maybe sigh of relief, that first one to get kind of off your back, especially for Boise State. It's their first weekend playing, and I imagine a little bit nervous I know I am when I, you know, start off the season, so kind of try to shake those nerves off. But Coach Garris did say that they want to focus on the things they can control this weekend. And right now they're struggling here with a side out, so trying to steady that out. Don't worry about what Stanford's doing necessarily, but be able to control your side and handle the ball.
Interesting that Coach Garris has six beach-only student-athletes, but the only time they're really together with the contributors from their indoor team is during their strength and conditioning workouts. They're still very much trying to piece together their roster and their pairings, but he thought that this trip to get on the road with the group would help build some of the chemistry that will sustain them over the course of the season.
Yeah, I think traveling together is always fun and brings some good team bonding, good memories, and he did actually come up to me before this started and said that they like to, when they travel, go do an activity or sightsee, and he said they went to the Stanford men's volleyball game last night and how the team just loved that. They loved the environment, loved to see that competition and level of play, and they really enjoyed it.
Simon will get a swing here, and a joust picked up by Anderson. Stanford looking for the side outs. They get a free ball. And finally, they take one step closer to the 21 required to win the opening sets. Anderson has a reputation as a hustler. She just doesn't have a switch in her brain that keeps her from going for any particular ball, according to her coaching staff.
It's a good quality to have.
They pick out Simon with the serve. And Anderson might get a review here as the referee comes down to check the ball mark. Still no decision.
That looked close from here, but we are a little bit farther away. Let's see what the referee decides.
Boise thinks the point is theirs, and it was deep. What do you think on replay?
Ooh, hard to tell. Looked like the line might have jiggled, but could it be the backsplash from the sand? So Boise was confident in that play, though.
Again, this point goes to Boise. Called out. Stanford with some margin, though, with a 10-point lead. Block pulls off. And now Stanford transitioning, terminating Kat Anderson. And she'll have the Cardinal in position to serve for the opening set.
Huge swing by Anderson. That was a great setup with a controlled, nice pass, perfect set. Really got up there and crushed it, put it away.
Anderson on track to major in neuroscience and become a neurosurgeon after her beach career. And with the block at the net, Caitlin Keefe pockets the opening set. For the five pair, the Stanford Cardinal, 21-9. All right, we'll step aside here on the farm, coming back with more Anderson and Keith, the second sets of the first flight, next on Pac-12 Network.
At Maui Gym.
For free at ZipRecruiter.com/Pac-12.
The fifth pair for the Stanford Cardinal gets an opening set win. And, Nicole, I thought it was really Caitlin Keefe's run of serves that helped them pull away midway through that opening set against Boise State.
That's right. There were a lot of aces coming from both sides. Aces and some not-so-great passes, I'll call them, but really need to get behind that ball and control it. The serving is tough. They're moving the ball around, but you got to keep those feet under it. And Boise State really needs to steady out that side-out game if they want to be able to score here against Stanford.
So Keith and Anderson coming off a straight sets victory against Tulane yesterday. They start this Saturday afternoon of competition well, ended that first set on a 15-5 run. They choose Simon with the first serve.
No one.
And Anderson with a clever cut to get the first couple of points for the Cardinal.
Great little chip there. Boise State playing two-down defense. She saw that, went for that little wrist-away shortcut, and those are the opportunities I was talking about earlier. Those free ball chances where you can score points to really keep yourself ahead.
Now Simon gets a chance to swing, block falling off, but she splits the Cardinal for a side out.
Luckily, they didn't crash too hard, but little miscommunication there on that middle ball. Those are always tough ones as it is, but calling it early can really help avoid those crashes.
A nice pass from Anderson, and she gets the swing for a 3-1 lead.
Anderson's really getting up there well. Nice high arm swing, swinging high over the net and keeping Boise State on their toes.
Now it's Keefe's turn. Over the block, but missed wide.
I think she's asking the ref to go take a look at that one a little close.
We've got a terrific camera angle on it. What do you think? Get it right?
It looks like he could get down to take a look at that one. That was a little close, so.
Nicole, you've practiced here at this facility. Can you just give us a few thoughts on sand depth, court conditions, kind of what it's like to play here as a student-athlete?
Obviously seen from the view everyone has at home, this is a beautiful facility. I know down in Manhattan Beach, Hermosa Beach, the sand is very deep there. So when we go to tournaments, that's one advantage. I think we've been training hard in deep sand. And after leaving Stanford, this sand is very deep as well. And it looks like it looked like it was moving there on that. I think the ball got that little outer corner of the line there. And looks like Stanford got the point on that.
Keefe knew it from the beginning. She had no doubt where she'd place that ball. Over on two and finds an empty spot on the court for a 5-1 advantage.
Very smart play there. Seeing the open court, quick reaction there on the on two and catching Boise State off guard. Great corner shot there. Those are hard to defend on twos.
They serve Hannenman this time. Looks like some indecision perhaps on the blocking scheme there from Boise, and it cost them another point.
One quick comment going back to this facility, but the sand depth can play a factor in timing, movement on the court. Stanford, obviously, this is their home court, so they're used to this sand. Boise State, I don't know their conditions there, but perhaps a little shallower, and so the timing could be a little different here for them to make those adjustments. Manhattan and Hermosa are also very deep places to play, so helps the vertical. Then when you go to shallow sand, you're much quicker.
Anderson with a nice kill over the block. We talked with Boise head coach Sean Garris about the facility. They do have a beautiful three-court outdoor facility in Boise, weather permitting. 50-plus degrees is kind of their threshold as that serve sails long as to whether they opt to train indoors or outdoors. Mishandled pass, and the Broncos get another point.
Nice flat bullet there from Simon from the end line. She's just getting a good hand on that ball, has good pace.
You heard the call there, and I appreciate our court microphones to pick up some of the communication from teammates. No one, no one at the net, and Kat Anderson cleverly terminates again for a 7-4 lead.
I think Boise State needs to make a little adjustment there on D. Simon was a little middle on that. Blocker pulled off. She's got to shift a little more to the left side. They keep getting that short cut over the net. So maybe make an adjustment to take some of those away to cause Stanford to work a different angle, different shot.
Simon, did she get a piece of the block? She did for a side out. I think important to keep Caitlin Keefe off the service line in the first set. And she had a run of 4 or 5 where the Cardinals separated. Here comes Keefe. Able to tuck it in. So 9-5 on the change in this race to 21, win by 2, and Anderson and Keefe looking for another straight sets victory. as they picked up against a ranked Tulane program yesterday. Three flights of action in this duel against Boise. Keeping an eye on the five pair. There's also an exhibition match going on. And we'll see 3 and 4 next for the Cardinal and the Broncos. Simon looking to go cross court and misses.
Just missed wide there, but that's the pass set that Boise State needs to keep with consistency there. That was beautiful. Beautiful pass, beautiful set. Just a little too much wrist on that cut shot that went long.
A second year on the fifth court for Kat Anderson. An errant pass takes the Cardinal to 11-5. An Everett Washington product. More and more, it seems, in our coverage of Pac-12 Beach Volleyball, we're seeing the Pacific Northwest produce collegiate student athletes in addition to the rich recruiting soil in Southern California. Good court vision there by Cassidy Simon on the kill.
Nice little pokey over the block to that end line.
Clean in system side out there for Anderson and Keefe. You can just see the rhythm that they've built over the course of this young season.
They do, and Anderson's moving the ball around. She's, as we've seen, that short little cut over the net. That was a deep one. She can hit hard line. She has a nice range.
And Keefe has benefited on a couple fortunate service rolls over the net. With the block up. Nice find there by Drew Hannenman. They've got some ground to make up against Anderson and Keefe to force a decisive third set.
Good time to get after that serve. Try to mix it up here and get Stanford into some passing trouble. Get some aces.
All right, so 14-7, second set on the switch. Anderson and Keefe looking to post the first match victory for the top 25 Cardinal.
Home of the Stanford Cardinal.
Aveline, 150 years under the hood.
Welcome back to the farm. About 60 degrees and overcast on a doubleheader day for top 25 Stanford. First flight of action underway against Boise State with members of the indoor program on hand to support their fellow student athletes.
That's right, Kevin Hambly, a little bit blocked right now, but on the other side of that woman, he is here supporting the team. It's nice to see the indoor coach here. He has several athletes on the team, and he's done an excellent job here, new coach to Stanford, and it's been fun. He was also my coach on the national team and also the Minnesota Chill Pro team, so I know him well, and he's doing a nice job here.
Definitely traditional for our Pac-12 programs as they establish, get up to full scholarship funding, have indoor contributions, and then steadily recruit pure outdoor players who can train year-round here on the sand. Anderson and Keefe just a few points away from a straight sets victory over Drew Hannenman and Cassidy Simon of Boise.
I think Keefe is the serving champion of this match. She's on a roll with many aces. Boise State's just not quite fronting her serve, and I think they can get one step more in front of that to get a pass on it.
A free ball to the Cardinal. Kat Anderson won't even get a chance over on two. Caitlin Keefe, and the family name, of course, has been synonymous. What am I talking about? Let's just say that the Keefe family name has had a long run here at Stanford. A lot of family history throughout her family tree.
Her mom was a very, very good volleyball player.
Twin sister here on the indoor team. Grandfather Robert Klein, a three-sport athlete in the Pac-12 at USC. Jimmy Klein, volleyball and football at Stanford, Uncle Patrick Klein. A 5 unanswered for Anderson and Keefe, and again with Keefe at the service line. And Stanford pulling away.
Boise State trying to break her momentum here with a timeout. They're really struggling here with a side-out game and got to try to find that rhythm.
We mentioned this is the first of two team duels today for the Stanford Cardinal. ASU coming up on Pac-12 Network, and then it's the South Tournament. They'll be in Southern California for duels against UW, Arizona, ASU, USC. That's the weekend of March 24th and 25th, and they continue against another top 10 program at Long Beach State. Those matches against ASU in the West Coast Classic can be seen here on Pac-12 Network. And right now, number 14 in the nation for the Stanford Cardinal and riding a 6-dual winning streak under Andrew Fuller. A light drizzle here in the San Francisco Bay Area. We thought that the rain had been called off of today's forecast, but hopefully shouldn't factor too heavily into play.
Not unless there's huge drops.
One of the longest rallies of this match, Drew Hanneman able to pick up a kill, and our audience, some of them at least, seeking cover. Anderson and Keefe, 2 points away from a second set victory. Looking ahead to our next flight of action for the Stanford Cardinal. We'll see the threes and the fours on the sand here at Stanford Beach Volleyball Stadium.
Stanford team's getting down there around court one with a few dance moves, getting ready for the celebration, I guess, of the victory.
Nice serve, and nicely done by the Broncos. Anderson and Keefe opting to take their chances. Cassidy Simon gets another service ace, the sophomore from Iowa.
That's that middle serve that can cause trouble for teams. You really got to call that ball early, decide who's going to take it, and be aggressive on that.
This time goes short to Kat Anderson. Is there net contact to interrupt the point?
Looks like a net touch by Boise State. That was a nice swing and a nice dig.
And it gives the Cardinal their first match point. Let's see if we can pick it up. Not much. But there's the match for Anderson and Keefe. They defeat Boise State to open our coverage at 9 and 10. So on consecutive days, straight sets victory for Caitlin Keefe and Kat Anderson. Looking forward to our next flight of action. We'll introduce the three and the four pairs for Boise State and Stanford coming up from Palo Alto.
Every athlete.
Family made in the USA since 1896.
Welcome back to our jam-packed day of beach volleyball from the farm. Stanford off to a winning start. They take court number 5 in straight sets, and they grab a 1-0 lead in this duel against Boise State. We'll also have coverage of their duel against Arizona State coming up later this afternoon. Let's take a look back at how Caitlin Keefe and Kat Anderson put together the win in the 5 pair. Nicole?
Not only did they put pressure on the service line with several aces, they handled the side-out game very well, mixing it up as we just saw over on 2 there and keeping Boise State on their toes. They really executed well today and very impressed with Anderson's range on her shots, hits, moving the ball all over the court.
All right, so the 5 pair with a 21-9, 21-10 victory, and their volunteer assistant, the Stanford Cardinal, Lauren Fendrick, an accomplished player in her own right, joins us as we prepare for the second flight of action with Nicole. I'm JB, and Lauren, just give us a sense of where the Stanford Cardinal have been so far this season. We know you challenge yourselves with the early opening schedule, but suddenly have found a lot of wins.
Yeah, we are out in Hawaii playing UCLA in Hawaii for our opening weekend. We played them both twice, and The first day was tough for us. We went 5-0 in both, or actually, yeah, 5-0 in both, dropping those, but we responded really well the second day and had a lot of really good progress going. So I think we've carried that into the rest of our season here, and we hope to keep building, keep growing as a team.
Now, Lauren, accomplished player that you are with many accolades, how has it been stepping into the coaching role for you here at Stanford?
Yeah, so this is my first time coaching in a setting that's not a camp setting where you see someone for, you know, a couple hours maybe. And I've absolutely adored getting to work with these amazing, engaging, intelligent, super interesting athletes. It's been so fun coaching them on the court, but then also getting to know them and the relationships we build off the court as well.
Andrew shared with us a little bit about the non-volleyball meetings, if you will, that the student-athletes really drive. You've challenged them to bring something new and engaging to the table, whether it's an article or a study that they've read recently that could present something competitive to the rest of their team.
Yeah, there's amazing research out there, and they're, you know, right up in it. So some of the studies that they bring in to us are just really interesting. One of them was about if you think about death before your performance, it actually improves performance. I know it seems like a morbid thought, but, you know, like, people are doing interesting research out there, and it's continually pushing us to just think about what we're doing and make sure we're doing things smartly and being open to ideas and utilizing the gifts of these student athletes that we have around us.
I guess we could have tried that last week in Florida before our last match. But
Or the panda suit.
That's right. So how about you, playing-wise? You're still playing on the FIVB, the AVP. What does it look like for you going forward this summer and living up here, obviously not in SoCal where most of the players are, but how do you make it work living up here in NorCal?
Yeah, so I have great training facilities here at Stanford that I utilize. I have my trainer in Santa Cruz. It's definitely difficult to commute sometimes, but you know, I have these amazing facilities, and it's so fun to be on the journey of my career and also be side by side with their journeys on their, you know, collegiate careers. And it's just a really fun interplay to get to walk by that. Like, they sent us that
oh, it was for us? Oh, I wasn't sure.
Yeah. A message from the team just wishing us well when we were in Florida, and you know, it was just so heartwarming to be able to know that they're following my progress.
I did catch you watching it several times.
I
came back in the room like, what are you listening to? You're like, oh, I'm watching the video again. But it's nice to see how happy you are here coaching. Still being able to play at such a high level and just having that connection with these student athletes, because it's nice to be able to give back, and through your experiences, I'm sure they really appreciate that and can talk to you about it.
Lauren, we're getting set to watch the three and the four pairs for Boise and your Stanford Cardinal. Can you give us a quick preview of what to expect in this next flight?
Well, for Kate and Courtney at the three slot, you can expect a lot of blocks. Courtney is our biggest blocker out here. She's, I mean, honestly, I haven't seen anybody on the world tour reach as high as she does, so be looking for that. Kate's a great little defender behind her. And then at the fours, we've got Peyton Chang and Kat Raquel. They're great setters and move the ball around a lot, so be looking out for some great matches here.
Yeah, dominant two-set victory for Chang and Raquel against Tulane yesterday. A win for Stanford to keep their streak alive against a ranked national program of the Waves. All right, well, thank you so much for joining us. It's nice to get your insight, and wonderful to check in with your program here with so many great beach volleyball programs on hand on the farm.
Thank you so much for
having
me.
And competitively, good luck to a couple Olympians as your tour continues.
Unless you're playing me.
That's right. Don't block me.
We'll take a break here and introduce our next flight, the three and the four pairs for Boise State at Stanford. Coming up. An overcast, cool but comfortable day here on the farm. As we continue with our Pac-12 beach volleyball coverage, number 14 Stanford got a win from their five pair to take a 1-0 lead in the duel against the Broncos of Boise State, San Jose State, Tulane, Cal, Arizona State, all on hand for this multi-team event. And we've got a doubleheader on Pac-12 Network, not just the Broncos and the Cardinal, but also the Sun Devils of Arizona State on the network against Stanford later today. With Nicole Brannan, J.B. Long, just a light rain falling as you see some of the umbrellas out here at Stanford Beach Volleyball Stadium as we prepare for our second flight of action. And we'll take a look at the three and the four pairs for Boise State and for the Stanford Cardinal as well. Jensen Allen is a 5'10 sophomore from California, and Kylie Lewis, a freshman from Washington, her partner. They've played anywhere from 3, 4, or 5 in the Boise rotation, but to begin this season, here they are on the 3 court against the Bowen and Formico team for the Stanford Cardinal. Courtney Bowen, a junior from Brooklyn at 6'4". She and Kat Anderson, who we saw in the 5 pairing, were a tandem last season. This year she's playing with the freshman from nearby Saratoga and Archbishop Mitty High School, Kate Formico, serves to get us started.
Got it on the bottom.
Three-time state champion, Formico also received All-American honors during her prep career. Some national team experience as well. First kill for Stanford belongs to Courtney Bowen, who had never participated in this sport of beach prior to 2016. She has since looked like a natural, hasn't she?
That's right. Nice side out on that first ball there. As Lauren mentioned, she is a huge net presence for Stanford, and even mentioned even on the international tour, not sure anyone could match her blocking, so let's keep an eye on that today.
And that makes this more of a classic tandem for Stanford. In some of the lower courts especially, you don't always see a true blocker, but that's what Bowen provides, and Formico's kind of learning to play behind it, isn't she? Or not need to play behind it, as
and
the
there's
case
a perfect example. I don't think anyone's going to be getting by that. Nice. Wow, she is just over that net, elbows over, hands just pressing right down on the ball. I don't think that will get by anyone.
And so Boise chooses to go over on two. And the Cardinal pick it up. The dig from Bowen and the termination from Formico.
Not only did she block, but Bowen quickly got off the net and got that short ball there, which is not always easy to do. So that was a great reaction.
That serve sails deep. Nicole, how much of a transition is that for a freshman like Kate Formico? Because there aren't a ton of, you know, 6'4" blocks at the prep level, at the junior level, in terms of the transition to learning to play with Bowen here at Stanford.
I think it just takes a little time to get used to the blocker, to not having the two down defense, where most of the time, as you mentioned, you have two down, you're balancing the court more on D, you're covering half the court, but with a block, Bowen's taking up an area, either line or angle. So Formico can then focus on, okay, I've got to cover angle and make sure nothing drops in the angle. Run down the high line if you see it, which we saw earlier, and get a touch on it if you can to keep that ball in play. But she has a great blocker for her. I think that can only help your defense and definitely get those extra points that are those tight balls at the net.
Jensen Allen serving for Boise State. A long run for Bowen. They had to rally, the Stanford team did, from down a set against Tulane yesterday. Bowen and Formico eventually prevailed at 21-14 in the second and then 15-10 in the third. Part of a 4-1 dual victory for Stanford. Service miscue there by Boise State. 6-4 the score in Stanford's favor. Bowen also splitting time indoor and outdoor, 3 days a week on the beach, two indoor for the Stanford Cardinal. A nice cross-court kill there, delivered.
Saw that open court in the angle. Formico moved over early to the line. Looks like kind of a setup play where Bowen's going to dive angle. Formico kind of gives up anything angle and plays for the line. Boise State saw that and scored.
Now, even though Lewis is the younger of the teammates for Boise State, she has actually more beach experience because of her junior career, the freshman from Auburn, Washington. Ties the first set at 6. And then mishits her serve.
Just nicked the antenna on that one.
Let me go here,
pass mishandled by Jensen Allen, and another point for the Cardinal.
If that ball was hit a little bit harder, you can take that, and it wouldn't be called a double. But if it's a roll shot, slow speed, you're not able to take that with two as she did there, almost like a set. But if it's a hard-driven ball, that would be an okay contact. But in this case, the referee didn't feel that that was hard enough to take it overhand like that.
Line shot there over the block of Bowen for Boise State. Also could see from our camera angle the coverage of Formico behind it as you described for us. Bowen either taking away the angle or the line. A missed pass there by Bowen. And here at the third pair, Boise State building a bit of momentum.
They're kind of peppering their serve back and forth between Formico and Bowen. They're not really focused on one player. They're moving it around.
There's a big swing by Courtney Bowen. I'll point out that there's another court of action underway here in this flight as well, and Stanford has the lead, 5-1. Chang and Raquel playing very well here in the month of March. A 5-1 advantage on Johnson and Hanses from Boise State. So those two courts side by side, and we'll keep you informed as this first set moves along. Try and get you any set points from either court. Chang and Raquel have won 6 in a row after Johnson and Hanses got the first point. Let me take a look over there and pick up court number 4. It caught the line, didn't it?
It did. It bounced right there on the end line, right over the blocker, pulling off the net. Coach Fuller had said that number 5, we see Catherine Raquel, has really embraced her role as a primary blocker. So before she was doing a little more defense, but in this pairing, she's more of the blocker and really taking that on. It's hard to switch sometimes. You're used to doing defense, or coach asks you to do something else and being open to it. So she's handling that well.
Previous pass too tight to the net, Boise State has back-to-back points. There's Chang looking deep middle and misfiring. So Kylie Johnson is a freshman from Texas, and this is Kenna Hanses, a sophomore from Washington. A roll shot earned Stanford a point off the hand of Kat Raquel, the senior from Los Angeles, 4-year contributor for this program. That misses wide.
Great pickup there by Chang, just reading that little cut shot over, and Boise State had a good idea with on two, but just hit that wide.
Junior from Newport Beach in Modern Day High School. Unreturnable serve there as she serves middle. Science, Technology, and Society major. Played in every match at the number 1 position as a freshman, then every match as a number 2 as a sophomore.
I think that ball can get up. The blocker was stopped. I think Raquel can kind of make that diving move to keep that ball in play.
All right, so Chang and Raquel with a 9-5 lead opening set. The 4 pair for the Stanford Cardinal. Let's go back and check in on the 3s. Jensen Allen serving for Boise State. And here comes Courtney Bowen. Misfires wide. And so Lewis and Allen have rallied here for a 12-10 lead. I mentioned that Bowen and Formico lost their opening set against Tulane yesterday, trying not to repeat that pattern against Boise State.
I'll admit I'm a little surprised to see Bowen getting so many serves, but she's making a few too many errors right now, so Boise State's exploiting that and keeping the ball on her. But if she passes well, as we saw earlier, and kind of crushes it down, she could be unstoppable. So trying to keep her in passing trouble.
And she'll serve and block here. Kylie Lewis able to beat the block and get a side out.
Boise State's chipping around well. They're not coming up and crushing the ball. They're playing smart. They're trying to take Bowen out of the game so she won't be as effective at the net by doing these little shots over her, shots around the block, and that can be very frustrating as a blocker when you're used to being in there and getting in someone's face if they're just kind of chipping it around you and taking you out of the game.
Formico to serve. See if Bowen can capitalize on the free ball. She does.
Here's one of those opportunities here. Nice pass and set. Just a little cut on the side of the ball there. Gets it down.
Formico will try it again as the block peels off.
Don't think you get any shorter than that on that little pokey over the net, even hit the tape and dribbled down.
Meanwhile, Chang and Raquel in firm commands. The four-pair match, 14-6. First to 21 here in the opening two sets. Win by two. Our second flight of action underway. Stanford with a 1-0 lead on Boise State. First of a doubleheader on Pac-12 Network today.
30 on Pac-12 Network.
Competitive opening set between the threes of Boise State and Stanford. We resume tied at 15, and Bowen and Formico take a 1-point lead in this race to 21, win by two.
Bowen putting some pressure at the service line with those middle serves and getting them back on top.
Now tell us about the challenge that serving middle creates.
Well, with communication, because the players might not know, it's not windy today, but sometimes the ball can blow one side or the other, but really being able to call that ball early. Take the aggressive stance, like, I'm not afraid to side out, I'm going to take this ball. Pass it, and right now Boise State's hesitating a little on that. Just that last pass, she went in for the pass, but kind of it looked like she wasn't so sure if I'm going to take it. If you take it, commit to the pass, go in strong and put the ball away.
Essentially putting the onus on the receivers to decide who makes the first pass as opposed to picking out a target with your serve and dictating their action, their
right.
side-out action.
And since this is Boise State's opening weekend with games, this may be a strategy to test out their communication and comfort level with each other on the court.
Just adjacent to the threes is the four pair of Chang and Raquel, now doubling up Johnson and Hanses of Boise State. In terms of the team duel, the fives for Stanford have already won. So an early team point in the duel, a 1-0 lead. Best of five on the duel wins the day. Chang with the dig there for the Cardinal. And also terminates.
All around nice play with a short serve setup. Great movement by Chang and Raquel there on the defensive pickup and putting the ball down. You don't have to serve hard every time. That doesn't mean you're doing a bullet or making it more difficult. But that short serve she did set them up for that play. And a lot of beach volleyball is a strategy and little cat and mouse game.
Raquel winning from the service line again. Looks like they're well on their way to an opening set victory. Let's go back to the threes where the margin is just two. Quite a scramble from the Cardinal, but not enough to win the point. Lewis and Allen back within one.
Nice block at the net, fronting her on that pokey and pressing over, and Bowen just not quite giving her that set and transition that she needs to get the ball down.
Now Formico returns the favor with a competitive play at the net.
Hard. 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 Hard.
That's an opening set that the talented tandem of Courtney Bowen and Kate Formico trailed, but they've rallied and are in position to claim the opening sets. That's a roll shot over the block of Bowen. Boise prepared for this 6'4" foe. We talked about their strategy to beat the block.
And one thing Bowen could do right now is, you notice the players are chipping around you, start pulling off the net, make a change. You don't have to stay at the net all the time. If they're not hitting against you, then make them have a different look. Maybe that'll mess up their shot, or you might get a dig. But she can pull short, she could pull back to the middle. Just try something different.
With the block falling off, she crushes it for a 19-17 lead.
She made that clear. You don't want to give her an open net. Put that right straight down.
Meanwhile, Chang and Raquel on a run of five straight take this 19-8 lead, and there's another on the service ace. They got a set point as they change sides. Formico looking for the cross-court kill, and she's got it. So set points on both the threes and fours for the Stanford Cardinal. Here's the test. Can we keep track of both courts of action? Time it just right. Boise keeps their hopes alive. Lewis and Allen. How about Chang and Raquel? Can
beautiful
they finish?
Hand set.
They
that
do.
Was beautiful. This is a huge side out here for Bowen and Formico.
And they don't even have to work for it. Just a service miscue to take care of the opening set. So the threes and the fours for the Cardinal claim the opening set. Our second flight of action of the day here from the Stanford Beach Volleyball Stadium. The Cal Golden Bears are here as well on the farm, entertaining. Let's take a look back at Courtney Bowen and Kate Formico claiming court one. It's our State Farm. Get to a better state. The opening set goes in their favor, although they trailed midway through, Nicole.
They did. Courtney Bowen got in a little trouble there with a side-out game and wasn't passing as well as I think she can. Boise State keeping the pressure on her. And Boise State chipping around that block, so that kept them in the game. They didn't let her have that kind of powerful net presence that we've been talking about.
Second set underway. Now, do the Dancing Cal Golden Bears, are they rooting for Boise here, or are they back in the pack and putting the Bay Area rivalry aside and Bowen and Formico?
I was wondering the same. I've seen a lot of dancing here today, so we'll have to catch some more athletes doing that.
I think some camera time was their only concern there, regardless of who claims this three pair. You talked a little bit in our previous segment about maybe Bowen changing the strategy and pulling off the net. What's the appropriate timing to make that decision?
Well, in that first set, Boise State, I didn't really see them hit any hard balls, hard-driven balls down. They were basically chipping around her. So I think if people are doing that, I mean, after a few points, you could mix it up, throw a pull in there to keep Boise State guessing and saying, okay, she's going to pull on me. I got to come up and hammer the ball. And it's like I mentioned, that cat and mouse game, like with serving, short deeps, just like with her chipping over the block, hitting one hard. And Courtney Bowen can play with them at the net, too, as well, by pulling and mixing it up.
Bowen serving here with the three pairs. Jensen Allen tried to work around her. And you know, sometimes you don't even have to block. You can just be the
That's
presence
right.
to alter the swing of your opponent.
And Boise State could also mix in some high hand hits. And by that, I mean going up, swinging hard for Bowen's hand so it flies off the top so that Formico doesn't have a chance to recover it off the touch.
Formico with the block falling off, picked up by Kylie Lewis.
Wow.
Scuffed by Bowen there.
That was quite a swat. Oh, that's a good feeling. You just see that ball, you're kind of hang time there, swatting it right back down. That was beautiful. Great reach there with the one arm as she saw that. Good eye work there to see the ball coming in slow.
Now adds a kill to her total. Seems that Bowen and Formico, you know, they took an opening shot from Lewis and Allen in that first set, but they've really responded well since.
Yeah, they've made some changes and more consistent, putting the pressure on them and passing better and taking care of those opportunities when they're getting the ball back over from Boise State.
So 6-1 on the change. And Bowen continues to serve. Lauren Fendrick helping out on that court. And another block for Bowen.
I can see what Lauren was talking about earlier about her blocking abilities. Those last two that we've seen have been very impressive. Boise State kind of has a grin on their face. Maybe they're not very high over the net. Boise State kind of with a smirk on their face. What do? I mean, I would probably say the same. Like, that's just a good block.
Thanks to Tom Feuer and Jeff Butler, our producer and director, for placing that net cam exactly where they did for the shots of Bowen rising above. And a service for Boise State. Well, that's one way to negate the factor of Bowen's imposition.
Good hand on the ball there with a top spin. Looks like it had a little side spin to it.
Tried to repeat it and missed this time.
After you ace someone, I like to get it back to that person. You don't need to do anything more, like that error that she made hitting the ball out. Bowen's in her head. She just got aced. Keep the pressure on that player so they're still thinking about it. You might get another point off of them.
I went a bit earlier, a bit quicker with that swing, and they beat the block to the top and got the point. Bowen passing well to set herself up for another kill.
She's passing well and putting the ball away. So if I were Boise State, I might throw a few serves over to Formico right now and test her out. You don't want a player to get too in a rhythm. And, you know, sometimes it's hard to remember that when you're in the match. But they got to throw a few serves Formico's way and test her.
Again, Bowen didn't block it, didn't touch it, but forced Boise State to adjust their swing and overhit it. All right, so 9-4 in Bowen and Formico's favor. Let's pick up the second set with the fours. And Chang and Raquel took the first set 21-8 and have the advantage here in the second, now 9-6. So Peyton Chang and Kat Raquel were dominant in straight sets yesterday against Tulane, looking for another two-set victory against Boise State in the first part of our doubleheader. Stanford and Arizona State coming up on Pac-12 Network. Raquel serving for the Cardinal. Now pulls off her block, and Boise State still finds a way to get the point. Kylie Johnson.
We'll probably see Raquel pulling a little bit more with this pairing just because she was playing more defense before. That's her comfort zone, but she is embracing the blocking role more. But until, you know, it takes a little time to make that transition. And
ooh,
that was a hard hit there. Checking if she's okay.
Kenna Hanses able to play on. Point goes to the Cardinal.
Didn't quite get those hands up. And it's just that quick reaction you got to have on that one. And sometimes it doesn't always go. I've had many facials.
A free ball back to the Cardinal. And the block there by Kenna Hanses. Kylie Johnson here. Misses long.
Just missed there. Nice long rally. Good ball control from both sides there.
They like Johnson. They call her one of their better beach-only players. Sees the court well. They think they can build around her for the future, the freshman from Texas.
Nothing tricky about that serve there. Just kind of one of those, I like to call them coaches' serves. Where the coach is just acing you off the court. They're not doing anything special, but they just have that little movement to it where can throw you off. You think it's easier than it is, and Got to take care of those ones.
Hanses beats the block for Boise State. 12-8 the score here in the second set.
Nice feet get into that set. It was a little inside there, and she moved her feet over to keep that right arm in front of it so she could beat the block.
Raquel with a big swing, deep middle. 13-8, Chang and Raquel in control. Second sets before pairing for the Stanford Cardinal with the Cal Bears dancing and on hand.
Network.
Still to come from the farm, we'll get our first look of the day at Catherine Plummer, a 2016 Freshman of the Year and a national champion. Followed that up with ABCA Player of the Year honors in the fall of 17. And oh, by the way, an accomplished beach player as well. She'll play in the next flight on the top court with Sunny Villapando, a freshman from Manhattan Beach.
Looking forward to seeing that team out here play. And Plummer, she's so accomplished indoor and doing the same thing on the beach. One of the best dual athletes I've seen do both indoor and beach.
Here at threes, Bowen and Formico perhaps closing in on a straight set victory. They were tested by Lewis and Allen in the first, but they have run away ever since. Formico serving with a 17-5 advantage. Looking for their sixth straight point on the Bowen kill.
They took that little break after game one and really changed it around. And this play is a perfect example. Nice pass, good set, nice ball control for Bowen to get up there and crush it.
I think Bowen told her teammate that's a perfect set right there, trying to return the favor. And Formico cuts one away from the defender and just two away from a match victory. Bowen and Formico.
Really smoothed out those plays there. In the first set, we kind of saw some sporadic setting from Bowen in these plays, but really nice, consistent pass set, setting up for that open cut.
And so it's match point number one for the 3Ds of Courtney Bowen and Kate Formico. A chance to give Stanford a 2-0 lead in the dual total. Jensen Allen trying to keep it alive. See if Formico can close it out. Doesn't even have to. Bowen with a smile takes a 21-18, 21-5 straight set victory over the Boise Broncos. So they end that second set in the match on a 9-0 run. And after a three-set victory against Tulane yesterday, quicker work for Bowen and Formico here this afternoon. Back to the fours and see if the Cardinal can grab a 3-0 lead in the duel against Boise. Kat Raquel with a second swing for the point.
Nice. I loved how she just slipped right into that middle pass right there on the serve receive. Finished well.
All right, so we'll pick it up at 17-11, I'm told, here with the fours of Chang and Raquel as they take on Kylie Johnson and Kenna Hanses of Boise State. Nice find that back corner as the block fell off. Hanses brings her pair back within 17-12. So the Boise program has already played San Jose State earlier this morning and now facing the Cardinal. A missed serve there. Kat Raquel serve for the Cardinal.
Boise State going towards Raquel, when she's pulling off the net, she's not getting, I don't think, deep enough on those pulls. They keep getting over her head. She did get a hand on that one, but it kind of flung behind her. So not getting deep enough in stop to make those digs, which with the more blocking she does and pulling, the better experience she'll get.
Right, tell us about that side winding serve down the line for an ace from Kenna Hanses.
Nice serve right on the sideline there. Switching up to serve Chang on that one.
And now goes at Raquel. Broncos able to pick it up and on two, another point for Boise State as they rally deep in this second.
Let's see what they do now. They've served one to each, maybe down the middle.
Back to Peyton Chang. Good rally from the fours, and Kat Raquel picks up the point for Stanford. Two away from a set victory and the match.
Great rally there, back and forth. Nice ball control by both sides, just able to get lower arm on that block and kind of chinked off her arm.
Boise on two and inside the line for a point.
Coach Garris was saying Johnson and Kenna Haynes have been working to embrace the good qualities that they can bring to the team and really focus on that and how that can help them kind of jump up and improve their game. Not much wind here today, so I don't know that there's a good side or a bad side, but if there was wind, could really use that to help you with a tougher serve, tougher hits to your advantage, but not much today.
Some players wearing shades, others not feeling the need with overcast skies throughout. Had a momentary drizzle in our first couple of flights, but not much weather to speak of. Match point with Kat Raquel serving. They'll take it. 21-8, 21-16. And a 3-0 start in the duel for the Stanford Cardinal with a number 14 national ranking and looking for a seventh straight victory. We'll chat with a student athlete when we come back from the Cardinal.
Credentialized.
Stanford in position for a sweep of Boise State as we anticipate the top flight pairs 1 and 2 upcoming. And we draw your attention to the score from the 3 pair of Courtney Bowen and Kate Formico, 21-18 and 21-5. And Courtney joins us now following that victory over Boise State. Congratulations. What was it kind of midway through that opening set that allowed you and Kate to pull away from the Broncos?
They gave us a tough run in the beginning. They definitely had some good adjustments that made us change our game. But I think the biggest thing was just our mentality and our energy. When we go out there and we smile and we have fun, we do so much better. And so in the timeout, it was a lot of just go out there and have a good time. Grateful for all that we have, and it really changed the momentum of the game.
I like it. And that first set, it looked like Boise State was kind of chipping around your block, trying to take you out of the game.
Yeah.
That second game, a little different story. So did you guys talk about that after the first set and what changes you could make?
Yeah, we did. Lauren Fendrick, our coach, is great with blocking tips because she, you know, one of the best blockers in the AVP. And so she's really helpful in terms of figuring out when to pull, when to help delay my block so that they can't get those shots around me. So it was really, that was her. She was some really good tips on that. And then with Kate Formico behind me on defense, I can take some risk, which is a great time with the block.
What are you learning about your freshman teammate as you emerge together in this 2018 campaign?
She's a phenomenal teammate in that she just gives you what you need. And she's really good at reading people. So when I get in my head or when I get in a funk, she's great at pulling me out, providing the energy that's necessary. If I miss my serve, she makes her serves. It's a good give and take. I'm really grateful for her.
We've learned a little bit about you during your career, including your love for music and also the fact that you've ridden your bike across country. I know it's a bit off beat here, Courtney, but can you just give us a sense of what it's like to bike from Massachusetts to Maine and Seattle to San Francisco?
Yeah, that was that's how I would spend my summers in high school. I was really into kind of pushing the boundary and physical endeavors. You know, college volleyball is a continuation of that. But yeah, so one of my summers I biked from Massachusetts to Maine, which was kind of my warm-up run, and then I did Seattle to San Francisco, which was 1,000 miles. We averaged 70 miles a day, did it over a 3.5-week period. I mean, it was awesome.
We're going to bring in Lauren, who you referenced, your volunteer assistant. She knows you better than we both do, to see if she has any surprise questions that can knock you off guard, because Courtney's been flawless so far today. Lauren,
I'm nervous.
You can throw at her?
Can't knock Courtney off guard. I've learned that. But I would love for you to expand on, you shared a little bit about it, what you observed, and you mentioned it in our little post-game debrief about the energy that you, the difference you notice when you bring a lot of energy to a match.
Oh, definitely. I mean, I think the first set coming out, I was a little tired. It was an early morning start. That's, you know, normal. We're in college. We're tired. And so I let that affect me. And I think the second set, I just made a decision to have a palpably different energy going out there. And it was different from the first, very first point. I mean, we got up, I think it was 5-1. And, you know, just going out there, being grateful for what's happening, being so happy about it. Even if you're not feeling it, fake it till you make it. And I think the energy changes so much. And then once you fake it that you're smiling, then you actually are, because we get great plays. Kate did some awesome digs. We put it away, got some blocks. And it's just a great start. So.
All right, 21-18 and 21-5, the opening victory over Boise State. We look forward to seeing you again against the ASU Sun Devils a little bit later this afternoon.
Thanks so much. Looking forward to it.
All right, Courtney Bowen there. And we continue with Lauren. Your group now 3-0, the lead in the duel on the day against Boise State. Observations from that second flight of action, if you would.
Yeah, like we kind of talked about, that first set was very tight. Boise State came out with some really tough serves and an attack mentality and trying to take Courtney out of the game, which was working for them really well in the beginning. But I think with those adjustments that Courtney was talking about, I think you can see how the physicality of Courtney's block with Kate's fast defense can really change a hitter's mentality. And that definitely happened in that second set. And then Peyton and Kat Raquel taking care of business on the at the fours position. That was nice to see. And we hope to continue here with the twos and the ones.
And with the ones, Catherine Plummer, just one of the really special student athletes in the entire country, indoor and outdoor. What's unique about her and her competitive nature?
I think one of the unique things that you wouldn't guess about Catherine is how good of a teammate she is and how much she wants to be a good teammate. I think a lot of star athletes can get very self-centered and all about me and my progress, but she is very team-oriented and cares about her teammates a ton and is really working to be a good leader out there.
And as we know, she's an incredible player, but what improvements have you seen from her this year on the sand?
Yeah, so she is working a lot on blocking. I'm working with her a lot with blocking. It's a bit of a challenge with 3 days a week, limited practice time, but she's really an incredible athlete that does things that I can't do, and it's interesting. It's a challenge to kind of convey these concepts that I know she can get to, and she has so much more potential in her, which is a testament to just really how committed and how hard she works out there.
Lauren Fendrick is our guest. One more question, and that would be about her teammate, Sunny. Why does the freshman from Manhattan Beach make for a good pair with one of the most talented volleyball players in the country?
Yeah, Sunny's our little spark plug out there. She brings the fire and the energy, which kind of meshes well with Plummer's kind of more cool mentality. And she's a fast defender, reads really well, and we're working on implementing some really high-level defensive schemes with them. So we'll see how we execute those here in this next flight.
All right, Sunny and Catherine coming up next from the farm as the Stanford Cardinal go for a clean sweep of Boise State on Pac-12 Network.
The Let's Have Flexes with yours, New York Life.
All right, welcome back to Stanford as our Pac-12 beach volleyball coverage continues. A doubleheader hosted by the Stanford Cardinal. They have a 3-0 lead on Boise State with a duel against Arizona State still to come from the farm with Nicole Brandt and JB Long. So glad that you're with us. Hope you're having a great weekend. And it's time to tee up the top court for Boise State and Stanford. Sabrin Roberts is a junior from Torrance, California, and she plays alongside Janelle Walley, a sophomore, and another California native. That's the top team for Boise State, which is just getting its season underway, playing their first competition here on the farm today. And we've already hinted at the top pair for the Stanford Cardinal, Catherine Plummer and Sunny Villapando, a freshman from Manhattan Beach. A two-time indoor MVP at MiraCosta High School, California State champion in beach volleyball. And what Stanford, from a coaching staff, has tried to preach to Villapando is that she doesn't have to have established success in college beach volleyball to feel confident of playing alongside someone like Plummer, because they put her on the top court and they believe that she can deliver at that level.
That's right. That can be, you know, coming in as a freshman as it is already a little intimidating. And then to be on the number one team with the best player indoor in the country and one of the best on the beach. I think it can add a little extra layer of intimidation, but Sunny has been handling it well. And as Lauren just said in her interview, she's a great spark plug for the team. Great combination here with Plummer. Their personalities balance each other out well. And I've seen Sunny play many times. She's a great defender, quick, reads well, and this is a great pairing for Stanford.
Janelle Wally's serve sails deep, so the first point to the Cardinal as our third flight of this opening duel is underway. The ones and the twos play between Boise State and Stanford. Villapando opts for the middle serve, and with the block up for Plummer, Boise State slides in the first point for the Broncos.
And we may see that same strategy from Boise State as we just saw with Bowen at the net.
Right.
Kind of chipping around the big block and keeping them out of the game.
Two missed serves, though, and you wonder if the talent of Plummer and Villapando kind of put pressure on Boise State to impact the game from the service line. They've misfired twice. Well, you name the accolade, and Plummer has put it together throughout her prep and now collegiate career. I thought Lauren's point was well taken about the teammate that she is and strives to be, in addition to her individual success and accolades. There's a point for the Cardinal.
That's right. That's nice to hear and important quality, and you can make the team better. She's already the best player, but if you have people around you with the chemistry, the camaraderie, bonding, can only be even better.
That set was off the net, and the Cardinal looking to capitalize in transition. Over on two, and the point continues. Good rally on the top courts, and Villapando puts it away.
Nice rally back and forth. Here we just, the ball can't decide, what am I going to do? Just a little hang time there on the net, and Stanford capitalized that point.
Wow, that was impressive from Boise State off a tough serve.
Little over on two, I'm not sure if that was intentional or not, but it certainly worked and got them the point for that switch.
Janelle Walley, one of the best volleyball players in the program, a smooth lefty, indoor and outdoor. And Sabrin Roberts, her teammate there.
Coach Garris said they're not a huge team, but they have the all-around great skills. Passing, setting, moving the ball around the court. And that was a great jump serve there, too.
Big point for Sabrin Roberts, the serve to get it started, and then defeating the block of Plummer.
A high hands pokey there off Plummer's block, just kind of going up, aiming for those fingertips to get a ricochet off there.
A nice deep middle shot there by Villapando, but you can see that the serve of Roberts could be a factor here. She misfired with her first, but has been on point since.
Those last couple are powerful. Get a little hand on that one, and she'll be tagging the sidelines.
This is Walley off balance, tough set to handle. Well, Henson Smith, the two pair for the Cardinal, had an 8-0 run, just stopped, but they've got an early first set advantage on Langley and Bulda for Boise State. Keep an eye on that two pair. From the Stanford perspective, Morgan Hentz and Amelia Smith, they were the tandem we talked about off the top of the show, honored as the Pac-12 Pair of the Week. Did not drop a set during the Stanford Bay Area kickoff. Play a fun style of volleyball. Looking forward to checking in with them. Straight set winner yesterday against Tulane as well to keep their momentum going.
Before Lauren Fendrick left the booth, she said, "Nicole, watch Morgan Hentz when she pulls off the net. She does some amazing digs." Lauren sometimes looks at her like, "What are you doing?" And then the ball's all of a sudden up. So keep an eye on that today, watching her pull off and make some fantastic digs.
She was up for the first block and then did pull off. Interesting that she's the libero indoor, but the blocker on this pair. We talk about two contrasting roles.
That's right. Way to be versatile. That's the all-around player there.
Smith picks it up, and now she'll get a swing.
Great set.
Did she catch the line? No, deep.
That was a great set from off the net. Pass was a little off, but Hentz got around that, squared up well to her target, and hit was a little long, but everything else looked good.
Back to the ones. Tied at seven as Sabrin Roberts serves from the opposite side. A couple of impactful jump serves. That'll work. It might be the best thing that Boise has going for it in the top pair right now.
Nice little rally there, and hence seeing the open court on two, catching Boise State off guard.
Kind of high risk, high reward with that powerful jump serve. A couple of service errors already. Again going early. Let's see what they do with the free ball here. Villapando and Plummer, talented though they are, suffered the only loss of Stanford's match against Tulane yesterday afternoon. It was decided in the third set at 15-12. So looking to bounce back today against Boise State. A service miscues, I think, costing Walley and Roberts a chance to claim this opening set. Villapando goes short.
That was an excellent serve. I couldn't even tell, looking from here, that she was going to be doing a short serve. Those are hard to read sometimes. People's approach looks the same if they're going to be going for it, and she disguised that well. Nice set.
Plummer able to get over the net.
That was another one of those full hands over the net. That ball's not coming by me here. Here we go with a good net cam. There we go, just reaching over and stopping it. Very powerful.
Not too strong from Sabrin Roberts. And so Plummer and Villapando building a lead. The top pair in the final flight of this duel between Boise State and Stanford. The Cardinal on top on the farm on Pac-12 Network.
You're watching Pac-12 Bay Area.
Sabrin Roberts on the left, Janelle Walley on the right, the top pair for Boise State. The Broncos beginning their season, a cold weather program, playing their first matches of the season this weekend on the farm. Sunny Villapando and Catherine Plummer with the lead by three as we resume first set, final flight of the day.
Nice serve coming out of the timeout there, just dropping middle.
Oh, what a get.
Wow.
Villapando kept the point alive. Now she sets Plummer. Here we go again.
Beautiful. First
hard
back set
point.
We've
My
seen
goodness.
All day. Way to mix that up. Goes front the first transition.
How about the backhand there from Villapando?
Nice little flipper dig there. Keeping that ball alive.
And now an ace service. So all the momentum in Stanford's favor here in the opening set.
Trying for the short serve on that one, but just a little bit too short. Villapando mixing it up with a short and deep, keeping Boise State guessing.
Two courts of action here in our final flight, and Stanford leading both, the ones and the twos, in position for the moment to sweep Boise State and keep their winning streak alive as Plummer cuts one across court for the 16th point for the Cardinal.
Beautiful hit by Plummer, cross court. I've also seen that from her indoor. Must be one of her favorites, but great hand on the ball, just a little side spin to get that down. Nice cut there by Sunny on the side out. Very sharp. That first set, Plummer looked a little frustrated with the blocking. I could tell Boise State was kind of tooling off her. She was a little bit high, and in that 21 break there, I saw her talking to Lauren Fendrick. Lauren just kind of calming her down, being be patient, it'll come. New team's got to kind of, make little adjustments as the game goes on, not let it get too frustrating.
Meantime, on the left, the two pair of Henson Smith, they're your Pac-12 pair of the week. Finding some great success here in the month of March. Langley and Bulda won the most recent point, serving for Boise State.
Andrew Fuller had said that Morgan Hentz actually had no experience on the beach last year. Mm-hmm. So we're talking last week, Pac-12 pair of the week, going from zero to being one of the top teams.
You can see her feel great for the game developing, though, as she went over on two there to steal a point and get her team within a couple in the opening set. And now a set point for the Cardinal. Yeah, Amelia Smith, the younger of the teammates, but the more seasoned beach player. And she will serve for the opening set for the Cardinal. Went down the line for the ace. And so the twos, Hentz and Smith, at 21-12, have an opening set. And over to Sunny and Plummer to see if they can do the same. Take at least another point to do it. 20-13, the updated score. Janelle Walley serving for Boise State and choosing Villapando.
Ooh, little tricky. Just when you think you're going to set the ball, you do a little back trick set there. Boise State was not ready for that one. Most people aren't, including myself. And I always get so annoyed when people do that, but you know what?
So the Cardinal just a couple of sets away. Pairs 1 and 2 from a sweep of Boise State. Back with more from the farm after this.
Hold on.
Well, it was a pleasure to be here for Pac-12 Network last season when Stanford University dedicated these courts to one of their all-time greats. Carrie Walsh Jennings was on hand. And a nice honor added to her resume from the Pac-12 last night in Las Vegas as well, Nicole.
That's right. She was inducted into the Pac-12 Hall of Fame. Just another honor to add to her long list of awards.
Four-time first-team All-American here on the farm, then a five-time Olympian, four-time medalist, three times gold, Carrie Walsh Jennings. The Arizona State Sun Devils are part of this multi-team event. We'll get our first look at ASU Beach Volleyball coming up in the back half of our doubleheader. First, Stanford looking to close out Boise State with first set wins on the top two courts. Plummer and Villapando come away disappointed to start the second after that scramble. 21-13, their first set win.
Villapando is all over the place. She is making great digs. That second dig there, probably Plummer could have gone over the net to give her a little more time because I don't think she was going to get up there to hit it over, but very scrappy play.
One more thought since we have the chance to tap into your experience and expertise. Can you quantify the impact on the game and on this community that Carrie Walsh Jennings has had?
Oh, yeah. She grew up here, went to Archbishop Mitty. She came to Stanford. I mean, she's such a wonderful player, wonderful person. She's done a lot for the community, and the court dedication is just one of the many honors of, you know, to see how they feel about her. And I think she's really grown the sport of beach volleyball and done so much for it, for Stanford, for herself, and now, you know, throughout her career giving back in many different ways, and looking forward to see, yeah, my current partner now going for Tokyo 2020, and we just started practices last week together, and so much fun, so exciting to be out there and get things going.
Well, I really enjoy when Lauren are around these courts or around the sport, seeing the student athletes light up to see how much you mean to them and how much they emulate you, both in terms of your stature and your style. I think it's part of why this sport has exploded at the collegiate level, and especially here in the Pac-12, where the conference has put a lot of resources behind it to grow the sport for these female student athletes.
Absolutely. They're so fortunate to have this opportunity to play beach volleyball, and it's fun to see them progress over the years. I've been coaching some of these student athletes at the high school level, and now to follow them in college and see how much they've improved and are helping these programs grow, and it's been a lot of fun.
Sunny Villapando will serve for the Stanford Cardinal, their top pair. A 4-2 lead in the second set. First two sets to 21 win by two. We have not seen a third set necessary today, but it would be to 15 win by two. 4-3 on the change.
Boise State kind of hanging in here early in the game.
Yeah, they've competed on their opening weekend. A late start to their schedule. Plummer winning at the nets.
Beautiful hand sets by Plummer, setting up Villapando for that. And scrappy play by Boise State, but just a little too tight on that dig right into a huge block like Plummer has there. It's going to be hard to get by.
Well, Villapando couldn't dig that kill.
Got the top spin at the end line now. Let's see if she can put some heat on this strong Stanford team.
Villapando would love to get Sabrin Roberts off the service line right away, and she does with a quick side out.
Well, with those sets, I think Villapando can side out all day long. They are beautiful hand sets. If you notice, a little bit lower than what we've seen today, a little bit of a quicker set that she's coming in to either hit or shoot.
Well, we're told to watch out for the left-handed swing of Janelle Walley, and that's proven to be the case. As she serves here. Villapando able to read that change of defense from Boise State and find the kill.
She's siding out well. She's really mixing up her shots, her hits. That was a rainbow shot, we call it, kind of that high, loopy shot to the corner pocket.
Now with the dig. Plummer, the enforcer at the net, builds the Stanford lead.
Great read by Plummer on that. She kind of hesitated, didn't jump too early. Saw Boise's seat coming down and waited and delayed. Swatted that back. Getting in her blocking groove a little more this set.
Misses the serve, and so 8-6. Stanford with the lead on the change, second set.
You can see Lauren giving her a couple little blocking tips there on the side. She might be telling her to stay low on the net. These Boise State players are not, they're tooling her a little bit too much on some of those balls. So if you get over low on the net, you can press over a little bit more.
I'm glad you're with us for Boise State and Stanford. It's been a clean sweep so far for the Cardinal. Straight sets at the fives, fours, and threes. Ones and twos in position for more of the same. Opening set victories for Plummer and Villapando and Henson Smith, the reigning Pac-12 pair of the week. Both controlling the second sets underway as well.
Powerful swing there.
Wally's talented.
Lefty. Coach Garris said she's the best all-around indoor and beach player that they have. Smooth player, good sense of the game. Lefties can be hard to block sometimes when you're a blocker. Used to blocking a right-handed player, so you got to make those little last-minute adjustments in the lineup. And
how about playing with a lefty? Similar adjustment?
I did last year, actually. So setting, yeah, setting's a little bit different, obviously. My partner was playing on the right side, so I would set her inside to the left arm. Usually I'm used to pushing it to the right, right-handed hitter there, so just little adjustments there.
Well, Walley and Roberts hanging tough in this second set within two of Plummer and Villapando. Abandoning the jump serve here for the moment. And just missed. The Plummer thought there might have been a touch on the block. To this point, unable to convince our referee.
Trying to ask her if she did, but let's see if we can see. Doesn't look like her fingers bent back at all from this angle, but let's see. Doesn't look like it to me that there was a touch. What do you think, JB?
Call on the court will stand. Boise State's point. Stanford sides out with Villapando.
Great up.
Everything but the result. For Villapando and Plummer with great effort, but we've got a 1 point second sets on the top court between Stanford and Boise State on Pac-12 Network.
The Network.
Pac-12 Beach Volleyball is brought to you by State Farm, here to help life go right. Back at Stanford University, glad you're with us for Pac-12 Beach Volleyball, a doubleheader today. Stanford hosting Boise State and later Arizona State. We have both duels for you. The top pairs and the final flights of this duel on the courts currently, with Stanford in position to sweep the Broncos. Second set action for the ones and the twos. Hentz and Smith, the reigning Pac-12 pair of the week, look like they'll have the first opportunity. The duel already clinched in the Cardinals' favor.
during the break there, saw some very good serving here from Amelia Smith. Missed that one, but really getting after that jump serve, getting on top of it. Nice hand. Boise State wasn't able to handle a few of those.
As the block peels off, Amelia Smith able to put it down. And so here comes match point number one for the twos. Morgan Hentz has the honor. Serving Bulda. Hits the deep middle to keep her tandem alive. Brindle Langley, a D2 grad transfer, and Jamie Lee Bulda.
Brindle Langley is the first all-beach player for Boise State.
Not the way they wanted to go out in the second set, but Hentz and Smith, at this point, unbeatable. They continue their recent run of success at 12-11, another straight set victory, and we'll see them this afternoon against the Sun Devils. The dual score now 4-0 in Stanford's favor. So we finish the final flight with the ones, Sunny Villapando and Catherine Plummer in the near court. Janelle Walley and Sabrin Roberts for Boise State on the far side. And on to a powerful swing.
Well, that's just unstoppable. Great setup there by Villapando on the pass for Plummer to just come in with momentum, get behind it, and just get all her power into that. Beautiful. Almost a slide, like indoor.
Villapando terminates and the lead grows to 17-11.
Stanford getting some separation in that little 7-point segment, getting most of the points there to give them a little cushion to finish off this game.
Now behind the scenes, talking to Andrew Fuller, we got a glimpse into what the Cardinal like to do off the court, and they take a different attitude towards competition than maybe some other programs, be they at Stanford or even other programs across the country. Mindfulness, meditation, a big part of what they do. They employ a sports performance psychologist. Also, I thought this one was interesting, a doctor who specializes in forgiveness. When you see the pairs playing together, they don't want them to be apologizing for the natural competitive mistakes that happen over the course of a match.
That's right, and I think we all are guilty of that. You miss a ball or a dig, and you're like, sorry, I got it. But obviously, we're all out there trying as hard as we can, and that's what he said, that we're all out here working hard. We know you feel bad. You don't need to say it. Let's not put that out there. And as we saw from Courtney Bowen's interview earlier, how she said she's happy, she's thankful, she's grateful, I could then connect the dots with what Andrew had shared with us and see how that really is a big part of this team and their success.
Student athletes sharing some of their gratitude with the community as well. They make regular appearances at the Children's Hospital here at Stanford, an enriching community service opportunity for this program. Seven of the last 8 points here in the second set belong to Plummer and Villapando as they look to close out this duel and get all five matches for the Stanford Cardinal. Boise unable to pick it up, and the lead grows to 18-11. Just looking ahead to the ASU duel. Unfortunately, the Sun Devils have experienced some injuries here this week, and that's going to shake up their rotation. So advantage Stanford in terms of the players who will be able to compete, but it'll be a good test from another Pac-12 program upcoming here in the second half of our doubleheader on the Pac-12 Network.
That's right. Got to mix some players around that could be to their advantage or disadvantage. Stanford might not know how to play those certain pairings, and maybe that can be an advantage for ASU.
Unfortunately, sharing the disappointing news, Brad Keenan almost helpless in terms of the shuffles that he had to make overnight with the late injury news. It's all Stanford against Boise State here at the ones and really throughout their lineup. Match point number two, and it'll be Plummer to serve for it. A float serve and comes in the block behind it. A big swing from Janelle Walley to extend this match.
Huge swing past Plummer's block there, showing her she's not intimidated by the block. Stanford really put the pedal to the metal, though. They were a little bit closer at the beginning of this set, and they came out of that break and really gave it to him and cleaned a few things up with the ball control and transitions.
And now looking to side out for the win. Now Sabrin Roberts, who has abandoned her jump serve, able to extend it to a fourth match point.
Possible chance for a timeout here, even though they do have a lead. You can still kind of try to ice the server a little bit or just kind of regroup.
Villapando with the pass to get it all started, and she terminates for 21-13, 21-14, a straight sets victory and a clean sweep for the Stanford Cardinal, who continue to roll here in their 2018 March schedule. So look back at this 5-0 sweep of Boise State without dropping a set, 1-5. A fine performance by the Cardinal. The Broncos just getting their season underway. Some valuable experience on the road here on the farm. All right, so as we've hinted at, a whole nother duel to cover upcoming as Pac-12's beach volleyball coverage continues with a Pac-12 duel next. Arizona State, the Sun Devils, and the Cardinals. Upcoming, we'll see you in about an hour back on the farm from the Stanford Beach Volleyball Courts.
We now join this program already in progress.